That tire's off the ground. And hold on, one sec. Yeah, hold on. You're gonna get awfully close to this rock right here. Welcome to another beautiful day of self-isolating ourselves in the beautiful Utah desert. Now, we are obviously on a trail, but before we got on the trail this morning, there was one thing we had to do, and that was to take care of a check engine light that we had on the Stepchild.
So it's another beautiful day out here at Sand Hollow. We got Jake with Coda the Jeep. We got the Stepchild. We're getting ready to load up and go hit some trails out there at Sand Hollow because, well, there's nobody out there, and it's going to be real fun. And America's Most Wanted just sent me a nice little gift package here. So as you know, America's Most Wanted is who we went through to get our Hemi swap done. And if you've been following along, you'll know that we did some damage to the vehicle lately. So here's what's really cool is that their Hemi swap is all catalog Mopar parts. So anything you pretty much need, damage, something goes wrong. Well, you know that my drive shaft broke. I damaged the O2 sensor and I completely mangled the muffler. Well, that's all wrapped up in here. Anyway, here's a nice new muffler. Of course, this isn't OEM from Mopar, but I think it's maybe Magnaflow. I'd have to look at it. But either way, we have a new muffler to put on. That one's not going to go on because that has to be welded in. But we're going to throw this guy in there, get rid of the check engine light, because I do have a check engine light on the Hemi from that rear O2 sensor being damaged. So let's take another look at what happened. So I did hit the exhaust here. Not a big deal. The muffler I hit here, not too big of a deal, but if you look up here, the drive shaft literally embedded itself right into the muffler there, and that's squished pretty dang good, the whole thing now. So you can see it is collapsed pretty good. So we're gonna replace that, and then the oxygen sensor should be super simple. It's right here. You can see that actually, when I came down on it, it shoved it up into the floor. And it just clips right here. So we'll just undo that, throw that in there. But I gotta thank America's Most Wanted for getting this out. They're always super amazing to deal with. Anybody I've ever sent to them has always messaged me back just telling me how wonderful they are to deal with. Okay, now they got the new sensor in. It's super awesome to be able to go into the taser and actually delete any codes that you're seeing. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do this with on the phone, but if you have a taser, you know that you can go in. I don't think I'm gonna be able to do this. You can go in and, light show, clear cells. Oop, cells cleared. And then you want to reboot. So the Taser JL lets you do all kinds of things. If you're new to the channel or new to the JL, it lets you go in and change your tire size. It lets you lock the rear locker with being in too high for when you're running sand dunes and everything. It lets you do light shows. It lets you change tire size, gear size, transfer case gearing. I mean, everything. So anyway, so I just cleared the cells. This little red light is your security light. So you got to make sure that you actually turn the vehicle off and then back on. Boom, look at that. No more check engine light. Anyway, for those of you guys who are new, Taser JL, right now I've got my tires programmed at, 40-inch tires, 513 gears. When we change the transfer case, I can change the transfer case gearing. I mean, there's so much you can do. Those are just the basic ones that I use it for. Sounds happy.
We're going to be doing a trail called John's Trail, and to get to it, you actually have to begin at a trail called Faulty Towers. They kind of share the same beginning, and then they split off. So that is what today's plan is.
Keep your voice. There you go.
See, it's crawling. Yeah. Let it crawl. Let it crawl. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Okay, right there.
Just straight up.
Now back it up and then walk through it.
He's crawling up.
Come on up.
I was just right seeing there. If you could crawl it.
I was seeing if I could crawl it, but now we can go back.
As you come up, stay 1 o'clock.
Get up.
So I sent a picture to my friend the other day and he goes, what are you going to do about your flat tire?
Yeah. But no, he was serious because he doesn't off-road. He didn't know
he didn't know what, yeah. Nature is definitely trying to smack me. That's why we have a Pro-Line wrap on the side of our Jeep. It helps to keep the pinstriping down a little bit. Chill. Nice and slow, yep.
Just a little bit. Alright, yeah. I'm trying to keep it from smashing the side. You need more driver. Like, straighten out right there. You're gonna skim the fender. There you go. Alright, you're gonna drop into a really big hole on your driver's side. And you're gonna turn a little passenger. Passenger? Right there, yep. This is gonna be the tricky part of not smashing your door. Maybe try to stay straight. See if you can come up straight. A little bit further. Oh, no, stop. You're lifting up. Stop. That tire's off the ground. And hold on, one sec. Yeah, hold on. You're gonna get awfully close to this rock right here. I think you need to go passenger, and that's the only thing that's gonna keep you from really getting into your door. You might wanna back up a little bit and come passenger, maybe. Just like a few inches, right? There. Cut a little passenger about 15 degrees. Yeah, maybe. We'll see if that helps a little. Probably won't, but you know. Because you're not. You're about to climb real far. Into that. Possible. We can try to keep you in that ditch a little longer. If he goes that way though, the only thing is, Kev, if you go that way, it's gonna keep your passenger rear tire right in that ditch and you're just gonna roll that way. Yeah, I'm telling you, yeah, that's what's gonna happen. You're gonna get too light on the front end. You're going downhill on your passenger right and you're going far, far uphill real quickly on your driver rear. Nowhere near climbing on your passenger rear. I'm not worried about you flipping right now. I'm telling you, you're not lined up for your passenger rear to climb at all. All it is it's gonna slide up against it. It's not gonna climb up. Driver. Hard drive. straighten out. There you go.
Worth a shot.
It was worth a shot.
Now you know.
But that was...
when your Jeep identifies as a buggy,
yeah,
you gotta give it a try. I think he
has to hug this side more than that side, but then the issue is...
Do you want to try it coming in more from this angle?
My only concern with that, if he's more that side, that tire's not going to climb as easily, and we might take out a taillight on that rock right there.
No, it'll go and then pivot and slide over, but then...
Yeah. Just climb up.
I don't think everybody wants to just sit here and wait for me, though.
We can be cool later. supposed to be a chill day. Kevin's over here just doing stupid stuff. I don't know why I'm surprised. What was that? Kill you.
That's what we all did. You weren't here to see it, but we all did this.
Subscribe and share. Remember, you can find all your Lite Brite Nation merch at lightbritestudios.com. All of your Lite Brite Nation decals at pixeldecals.com.
And don't forget
e3offroad.com and the Gladiator giveaway, because that is still going on. That is still happening. And we are still giving it away in October. Guys, we love you so much, and we will see you next time. Bye!
Also, don't forget that when we're wearing this in the next video, the same outfits, it's because...
Well, we're probably going to hit more trips.
Yeah.
Right now.